Let's Hunt is a video series with tactics, weapons, locations, and other useful tips, always around one particular animal. Hello again! In the Whitetail episode, we're going to mostly focus on the locations where you can find whitetails without having to put out a tent. There is a number of lodges and directions where you go where you will find whitetails in abundance. There's a number of clothing sets available that work against deer, and for the whitetails I'm going to use the trapper outfit. The first place is the South Cliff Lodge on Whiteheart Island. It's the southern lodge down here. There is a lot of whitetails in this area, as you will see. They're also up here, but there we will also find elk and coyotes, but still whitetails are there in abundance. The starting time is 7 o'clock, and if you start at 7, there's always a mushroom here. Just kidding. So let's get the weapons ready. This is a fun shotgun. It's a rusty old gun, really. It's not very fast reloading, but I like the sound, I like the look of it. And it's actually quite good for rabbits as well. Very reliable. I also bring the python bow. And that's always good for some silent kills. So from here I'm going west and north. And very soon we should hear some whitetails calling. In a few cases there will be elk calling us, the first animals, but that's really rare. In front of us is an open field with a tower on the side at the end of the field. I'd love to have that tower in the middle of the field for a 360 view, but I think that would be too overkill there. Plus it's also more like in real life where you would have such a tower at the edge near the trees where you can be seen less from the animals or by the animals. There's a certain radius around the lodges and tents where you start where there's no animals. So you have to walk out a little bit. Seven o'clock is nice. You have some daylight already. If you start at 5 and you look far into the woods, it's hard to see animals, but at 7 you've got good daylight already. There's more females around than males, but any whitetail could be either male or female. And now when I'm calling, I might actually attract more than just the one that just called. The females are not very aware of the environment. You could almost run up to them and they will still not notice you. So this is the open field I mentioned. Nice place for putting a scent trap, putting some scent spray, and sometimes you have multiple whitetails walk into it. So we're just about to meet this first deer. When it comes closer, you can hear the steps. Oh, there's a buck as well. Now he sees me. As usual, lay flat on the ground, move behind an object, and he will continue to move on. There's another buck. So this is the proof that there is many whitetails here. So there's the buck, let's go for that. So the first call attracted three whitetails. This place is packed. I've shot some really good trophies here. This one is like a small 130-ish buck. Even less, 115, 116. Some people run out of the lodge to overcome that no spawn radius of about 150 meters. You can do that, but it's just if there's any larger bucks or any bucks in general, they will run and spook everything else. As we go up here north, there's going to be another tower, which is a nice view over another field. So this is another female. That's not the one that called, or I would have two red dots on the hunter mate. This is a different one. Oh, I didn't pay attention to the time. Yeah, 5 minutes and it was fleeing. So that is the proof actually that there were four whitetails attracted to the call, or at least in the area, and the shot made three of them, all three of them run away. So anyone hunting whitetails or preferring whitetails should try this place out. It's almost boring if you look for diversity before you really get further up. This is a new buck. As usual, I call and move closer. Depending on the animal, I will keep walking or I will start crouching. With the bucks, you always have to consider that this could be a bigger one, so you want to be careful. The most important is that you can spot it. If it spooks, then that's okay, you can go after it. But if you have spotted it first, you know whether it's worth it. Just by the weight of the whitetail buck, you cannot really tell if it's going to be a good one. If it's a very high weight, the chances are good that it's going to be a high score. If it's a very low weight, it's most likely a small buck. But anything in between, the maximum weight is 100 kilograms. So there it is. And so anything above 85 kilograms can be a good buck. I'm using scent eliminator here because I'm going with the wind. North, northeast is usually where the wind blows. If you look at the leaves there in front of me, they're flying right in the direction I'm going. So this is where the wind blows. So this is the 130-ish buck that I was expecting before. Nice looking rack, but it's missing some tines in the middle. Plus the tines at the ends are not very long. The spread is good, the spread is okay, but it's the missing tines and the tine length. So let's harvest this one with the bow and then move on to the next location. Well, if he's not coming to me, I will go to him. Staying behind the tree. As much as I can. And when it's within 20 meters, that's good enough for the bow. So much for Whiteheart Island, let's move on to the next place. The next place I want to show you is on Settler Creeks, starting at the Highland Lodge at 5 o'clock in the morning. Go east from the Highland Lodge into the highlighted area. You will find a lot of whitetails. There will be other animals, but the whitetails clearly prevail. It's really interesting, depending on the time of the day where you start, you find different results. And I've started here some time ago at 5 a.m. and I really found whitetails, and I started again at that time. And it seems to work. This seems to be the time of the deer. Again, of course, here it's the same with the females being more than males. But if you can find many, many deer, then you will have plenty of bucks among them. today it's a female. That is first to call. But usually there's a number of whitetails around. There could be bucks now also be attracted to my call. So usually what I do is I take out any disturbing animals like this female with the silent python bow and then go to the tower. And from there I get more activity from more deer. If you can see the doe, let me know. And sure enough, there is a buck. Ooh, very close. Attracted to my call, pretty sure. It's probably going to walk from left to right here. I'm not hearing the female. Now I do. Probably best if I try to get this buck down here. Not a big one. But we have two whitetails already within a few minutes. So with a rifle I could easily take this out. But then of course I would spook everything else. So what I'm going to do is I will approach this one, take it out with the bow as well, and then move on to the tower and beyond. scent is not a big issue. I'm hunting into the wind here. So you can get really close, 11 meters. You can take them out nicely, and even the bucks will not see you when you lay down and then get up. I continued my hunt, but the demonstration of this location ends here. I recommend you go check out this place for yourself. When we talk about whitetail deer hunting, of course the Red Feather Falls Reserve cannot be missing from the list. I'm here at the Trapper's Rest Lodge, and from here you can go into pretty much any direction. You will find whitetail and also moose. They're about the same amount of animals, roughly, from these both species, but it's these two only. You have to go further north until you find other species. So this is great for moose and whitetail hunting. I will go northeast and then head east over towards, there's a nice swampy area where there's always a lot of whitetails. What I have tried doing in the past was crouching through the area, calling all the time, and also using scent spray. And at some point I had accumulated 5 or 6 whitetails in the same place, so they really come to that places that you lure them to, and it was a really interesting experience. So you can try that as well, but here I'm going to just walk and wait until I hear a call, and lo and behold, there is the first call. Since it is a buck, I will use the scent eliminator as well. Preferably, I will shoot it with the bow so that I can stay silent. And now I called. I would not be surprised if there's any other whitetails approaching to the calling location. So for any animal you hunt, for any situation, whenever you call, just keep moving. If you want to be safe, just move left or right or backwards. Because when you call and move, they will come towards you, they will see your movements. It's a bit risky, so until you have a little bit of a feeling for how close you can crouch to animals, just stay there as far as distance-wise, just move left and right, keep looking at the environment to make sure you're not overseeing any animals. I don't have any cover here, so I will slowly move behind the trees. Everything else is just risky. So even these movements here, the buck might be actually looking at me already. So I will go prone better. I would hate to lose a buck just because I was not careful enough. I always want to spot it, so So that I have an idea of the possible score. This one is about 80 meters away still. And of course, the animals, when you call them, they will come to you pretty much straight. It's rather easy to estimate where they will come from. And if you remain silent and hidden, then in most cases you shouldn't have a problem harvesting them. This one is a rather small buck, somewhere around 70 kilograms. But I still want to be careful, especially since I don't know what else is around. It was just sticking the nose in the air. That is a warning sign. That might mean they actually smell you. Just looking if there's any others. So this was a 20 meter shot with the bow. They are usually pretty safe. When they come from an angle, you can nicely penetrate both lungs. So they instantly die. If the lungs are so bright red, you have hit both lungs and it says right lung and left lung. If you only hit one lung, then the picture of the lung will be a bit darker, like all the other organs. There's the next call already. The only disadvantage starting here is you're in the open area when you start, when you come up here. There's no trees, not many trees to hide. And now here we're getting more into the woods, into the deeper forest where you have a chance to hide. But then of course you can also move closer before you even call until you reach the forest and then only call from there. Checking the area for any other deer. I have been calling off quite a bit, three times already. But bow hunting is really a lot of fun. Of course, with the guns, it's a lot easier. You can shoot them at sight, any distance you can shoot them. But of course, you're spooking everything. And bow hunting takes a bit more skill, bit more tactics. But you're constantly silent. That's really a nice thing. Perfect angle. Parker is actually pretty strong over short distances. You can kill moose and elk over this distance immediately. But once you go to 30, 40 meters, sometimes you only penetrate one lung and the animal is running, so you have to spooking anyway. There's a few tracks here, and it's whitetail or moose for sure. In this case, it's a moose cow. And another buck, very nice. Over at the water. If you are into competitions, of course you sign up for them and then just go and find many animals. And the more you find, the better the chance you will eventually get a big one. Sometimes you're lucky your first one is a big one. Sometimes you don't find any good ones for weeks. Just the way it is. This one looks nice, but the score is just average. Here's another track I want to check out. I'm wearing the trapper outfit, and the visibility reduction is not as good as with the Boone and Crockett. It's less visual protection, but more scent and noise protection. So you have to be careful when you move around. going to try and steer it over here to me. And I'm going to use the shotgun, because after this buck, we will move on to the next place. Alright, another nice buck going this way. Okay, so the next place is going to be very close from here. Guess what it's gonna be? Of course, the next place is the Darkwood Lodge, also here at Red Feather Falls, and this is even a better place. Going south from here and then west towards the Trapper's Rest Lodge. This is Whitetail Paradise. There is a few Roosevelt elk around and later moose, but right now mostly it's whitetails. So I'm gonna go south from here and hopefully we get a first call from a buck. If it's a female, if it's a doe, that's fine too. We'll take her out silently. We'll be looking for tracks and waiting for calls. And as usual, I'm expecting the first call within the first few minutes, of course. And there it is. The female, we can go quite aggressively. And since we're going south, not that big of an issue with the wind. There she is. Now I called so I could expect any other animals, any other deer. Very close now. So I will continue crouching. Again, the goal was to take out this doe before she calls a second time. So now the call, the next call should come rather soon from another animal, if there's any around. but I'm pretty confident there will be. This place is usually packed with whitetails. And it's a buck very close. He's facing the calling location. Just could be crouched. It's a decent looking buck. Heavy. Very nice. So he's going to be a nice trophy. But I have to be much more careful around this guy. He's coming rather quickly. So I better move behind this tree here. And we get some rain. .157, that's a nice score. I'm going to reduce the volume because the rain is really loud. And there's the next animal coming, the next deer. Once you start calling, you can't stop it. This is still too loud for me. So another whitetail buck. This one is rather small. So if you ever doubt, this place is not good for whitetails. This should be the proof that this is really full here. You can crawl almost underneath a whitetail though. But I should take her out now. So that we also get the buck. And we have not received a call in a while. And there is the call. I was just going to say I should take him out quickly before he calls. But then you have to be really fast. python bow is really reliable over short distances. Usually you get double longs. So it's 10:17. So roughly 9 minutes playing, 4 white tails down. This is whitetail hunting at its best. And that's another buck. So when it's raining, you can walk around a bit safer. Animals will not hear or see you as well. Well, I'm not sure about the seeing, but they cannot hear you as well. So you can move much closer to them. So the rain is fine if you're hunting in the woods. But it's not so good if you want to go for longer shots. And the elk cow here is going to terminate the whitetail hunting here. I was hoping for one more whitetail. Oh well. Last but not least, we come to the Rougarou Bayou Reserve, starting at the Whispering Woods Lodge in the north. I'm sure you think of Rougarou as the duck hunting place. This is where you hunt ducks, of course. But when you start up here in the north, as you walk down the western side, you will run into whitetails left and right. This is a great place. You can also spread out here. And the first call here is always, 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 really always a whitetail. It's funny. Somehow only whitetails spawn up here. Very soon you will also run into feral hawks. And of course the black bear, although the black bear is more in the east. So you want to come here, check this place out. I'm starting at 10 o'clock in the morning, and fairly soon I should get a call from a whitetail. There you go. And as usual, I call them. This is fairly open. There's no place to hide here, so the doe will come towards me in the open. I'll have to be careful. There she is. And as usual, where there's many whitetails, you will attract likely more than one. So I will start this hunt with the bow, just as I've done with the others. She's behind the hill now, so even better for me. Hard for her to see me, but soon she will likely hear me, so I will go prone. There's no reason to risk anything here to gain a few seconds. might work out just perfect here with the hill. I'm coming up from behind the hill. And just when she appears, I can shoot her. As always, I listen first if there's any other animals nearby. Again, she took the call or the calling slot. I was not fast enough to shoot her before she calls, so I have to wait for the next call a few minutes. And in those few minutes, you can run into the animals that were approaching. So I'm going to be a bit more careful here. One reason why the first call is always from a whitetail is because the bears don't call. And the pigs do not come up here. Oh, there is a buck. Pretty close already. Maybe 100 meters out. We can hear some ducks in the air. This is the duck hunting place for sure, and I'm thinking many people do not come to Rougarou for hunting pigs or whitetails, but actually, since they are so dominant and there's no other species except the bear, which doesn't call anyway, I think it's actually a really, really good place for whitetail and feral hawk hunting. If you then go to the very south and go up the coast towards the east, that is just full of feral hawks. That is almost exclusive feral hawk hunting ground. Now I'm a bit in a disadvantage here. There's some shrubs that I cannot look through, but the deer can look through them. Anything in the game that you can walk through or the animals can walk through, they can see through, even if you can't. You cannot hide behind the bush. Or in high grass, in reeds near the ocean, they will still see you just as much as if there was nothing. But there's no need to rush here as well. The buck is already close. And even if you have come close, once you get up, when they see you, most of the time you still have the time to draw your bow. This works with the python and with the snake bite. But the recurve and the longbow take longer to draw, and many times the animals will just run away. Now we have some time to spot it first. It's the average whitetail rack. Many, many bucks like that walk around. And from the front, we should get the vital organs. And this is not a problem at all. So I will continue just going south down this western wing of the map. You can go all the way down. The further down you go, the further south you go, the more picks you will find, the less whitetails. But for a nice day out hunting whitetails, this is really perfect. There's another doe. Any doe you find, any buck you find, that is just a spawn of one animal. That could be any gender. The distribution between males and females used to be that there was... we get a call. The distribution used to be there was 2 males for every 3 females. So about 60% of the animals used to be females, but that is a really old information dating back to 2011 or so. That's more 4 years. 4 years old information back from the old community manager. And really only in 2011, I'm trying to think, they had maybe 3 maps, maybe 4. No, I don't think it was 4 maps. And a lot less animals. A lot less animals. Actually, that was in the beginning of when I started to play. And back then they had Whiteheart, Loggers Point, and Settler Creeks. And in those reserves, maybe 8 species. So the 3-to-2 relation could have been valid for those species. Nowadays, I don't know if that's still valid for all species. And of course, I also don't know if they have ever changed that. They might have changed the numbers a little bit. And we will never know. I'm not so much crouching here because of the doe that I'm going to face. It's still rather far away. But because simply the calling will keep attracting animals. And I've been calling, I've called a few times already. I might have animals wandering after me. This is always worth having a look to see if there's anything wandering down there. And the first feral hawks can be seen going from here forward. But still, the whitetails are predominant. Oh, there she is already. Not the perfect way to approach her, and she spooks. And while she spooks, I'm thinking, should I be angry about what happened? But then a buck calls, which is even better. I was just going to say, I'm not approaching her ideally, coming from the side. Sometimes it appears to me they can spot you better when you come from the side than when you come from the front. It's kind of weird. But like I said a few times throughout this series, or throughout this video as well, I'm going rather aggressive usually, right up to them. And of course, if you do that, and if you gain experience by doing this, if you try your, where's your limits, how far can you go, how fast can you go, of course, you have to spook them in order to learn how they really behave. And here I'm totally out of cover, completely out of luck here. I could go closer, but then I have to go prone. And the problem there is I will not see anything. I will be down in the grass, down in the reeds. And it'll be somewhat risky. So I will just wait here. Let the buck approach. Maybe I get some other signs. Going south has the advantage of hunting into the wind. The animals smell you a lot less. We might be okay for a shot with this shotgun, but I need a clear line of sight here. Was not a deadly shot. He's going crazy there. Coming back. It was actually a pretty bad shot. He's still going. Hello. So let's go find this guy. One more track from a buck. Of course, I hope he's gonna calm down rather soon. And you always take the positive out of things. The fact that I shot it badly gives me the chance to see a few more animals here. Actually, I think I can walk. He's going to die. It was an intestine shot. I missed the lungs. And now he's bleeding to death. Just died now. And as you can see, there's more tracks from other animals, from other whitetails. And I hear an animal run. So, this is a good place, really. It's a fun place. It's a good place for something different. It gives you some diversity. If you have been hunting on white heart or red feathers, I suggest come to Rougarou for some whitetail hunting. This is really good stuff here. The only problem here is with the tracking and with the crouching, sometimes with the shallow water. You can get stuck, or the tracks will immediately change to something, to a different direction, because the animal got stuck. That's the only challenge here. See it as a challenge. Many open places where all the water is, so it's a bit more challenging hunting whitetails here, hunting feral hawks. But I quite like it every now and then to go here for something different. Okay, this is going to conclude our little video regarding locations for whitetail, and hopefully you can use one or the other tip and go to some of these places and check them out. Have fun. I hope you enjoyed, never got annoyed. Thank you very much. Stay in touch.